This Memorial Day weekend, a lot of people will be headed to Lake Nacimiento. Water levels there are at their highest, actually the highest they've been in decades. It is, of course, a boater's paradise, but it is creating some problems for people looking to set up shop at their favorite campsites. Action News reporter Tom Miller is live at the lake with more for us tonight.
Laren, these are the highest levels at Lake Nacimiento since 1986. But all the fun that goes along with that is being jeopardized by two different types of freshwater mussels. So the park is doing all it can to keep them out.
So I just need to pull on. We just need to make sure there's no water in there.
For the first time, rangers are screening all boats before they come into Lake Nacimiento for the invasive zebra and cuaga mussels.
These mussels will totally change the food web in a lake. They create problems for boaters because they impact the cooling systems. They get in the cooling systems and stop the boat's ability to cool itself.
About a dozen lakes in California are infected, and rangers don't want Nacimiento to become the next one, especially with the lake so full and in spectacular boating condition. Because of our very wet winter, water levels are as high as they've been in recent memory. At this picnic table, I'm okay. I might just get my feet wet, but at some other tables, you'd be up to your chest if you wanted to enjoy lunch.
It's nice to have all the water, and less people are here because the campsites are all gone, so that not as many people can stay up here.
Greg Ayaga is one of the lucky ones. He got here early enough to snag a waterfront campsite. This one may be one of the best on the lake, but lots of regulars will be disappointed to find their favorite site underwater.
We've lost our entire overflow and about 20 spaces in our Pine Knoll campground.
More water means more room on the lake, but they're still rule breakers.
So I'm not going to write you a ticket today, but understand on a holiday weekend, we write a lot of tickets out here.
He had his mussel inspection papers.
So this is what we're looking for. He's got his mussel screening permit all filled out, stamped officially. That's perfect.
So he was let go to enjoy the mussel-free lake for the rest of a gorgeous Memorial Day weekend. And the inspection shouldn't be too much of a hassle. They take 3 to 5 minutes, unless something seems off. In that case, the inspectors will pull you aside, and it could take up to 30 to 40 minutes. Aaron?
It's going to be a busy weekend. Thank you, Tom.